Hey everybody, welcome to my basement studio. I am going to be doing a little bit of airbrushing today for some sludge models that I have just kit-bashed, created, assemblaged, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to be doing some airbrushing. This is my little airbrush compressor and my Paasche Talon airbrush. And if you hear any background noise, well, that will probably be due to the air filter, the fan on that going on. And also, I've got a little air filter here to clean the air a little bit. Keep it a little less smelly down here. Because it's winter right now, in the middle of winter, so I can't open up any windows. Also, just so you know, when I'm airbrushing, I'll be using a 3M NIOSH mask. So probably won't be talking all that much when I'm doing this stuff. And then I'll be running some subtitles, hopefully, during the production. Post-production, you know. I'm going to set up my little GoPro camera right here, so we can see what's going on. So yeah, I'm going to just be doing some priming. And how I like to set up my primer is I've got my airbrush all set up here. I'm going to grab... I'll show you a little bit of what I'm priming today. First off, I'm going to be priming a bunch of these Gabions. These like these guys Mike 3D printed for me. I'm pretty happy with that. Buddy Mike gave me those. So that's for some terrain. I've got those puttied to a long stretcher bar. I like using that just to hold them all in one place. And then I also, I don't know what you'd call it, kit-bashed, converted, whatever the terminology is. This thing, which is, this is a battle kite that I just added a whole bunch of gears and bobs to. Big propeller in the back. A bunch of dangly strings on the bottom. I figure that's like it can carry guys in the battle, so they maybe hang off of those strings. Who knows, right? Figure that out later when we go to battle. And then inside the cockpit of that battle kite, I've got one little pilot friend here. This guy has an old pig iron gas mask on, and he's going to be pointing, and he's got a pole that's going to have a, what do you call it, a flag on it. Got to have a flag. All right. And then here is the pilot that is also going to go inside it. I think that's going to be kind of fun. I got a pilot. He's holding a weird stick thing, and then he's got his arm positioned. So when he's in the... battle kite, he'll be able to look like he's steering it. Okay. All good. I am going to use a number 2 Paasche needle. Usually when I set this guy up for priming, I like using a number 2. It gives me just kind of like halfway in between. I have to find my needle that's not bent. This is the one that's bent. It's got a little bit of a barb on it. Around that end, I could file that down, get some emery paper, and sand that down. But I like using a number 2 for priming. It's just, I don't need the full spray of the number 3, the TN3. So I use the number 2, find the tip for it. This is a good tip. All right, put this guy together. So, yeah, when I'm assembling this guy, I usually don't put the needle in through the back. I usually put the needle in first and then adjust the tip there. I'm going to get that seated correctly. That's all pretty good. And then, make sure that's on there tight. You know, sometimes I take this guy apart. I haven't airbrushed in a few weeks, so, kind of got to make sure that everything's all groovy with this. I'm going to make sure that I can get that trigger almost all the way back so I can get full flow if I need to unclog it. Primer, you know, being a little bit thicker and stickier, it likes to stick on that nozzle. So I'd like to make sure that that's all set to go. And then when I airbrush, I almost always kind of put a little bit of water in here. Just to see how my flow goes. You know. It's looking pretty good. Consistent, not spotty, all good. Make sure that my moisture trap is good there. Fantastic. How I'm going to mix up my paint today is I really like this Stinel Res, is that what it's called? I never actually tried to say the word out loud. But Stynylrez. I really like using this stuff. It gives a nice, there's the water out of there. It gives a nice even coat for me. It's basically airbrush ready. I always throw in, let's see if I can find it, a little bit of flow improver if I can. Maybe I've got a little bit left here. No, that one's empty. That's always great. Interesting. Might not have any flow improver in there. So, instead, just gonna drop a little bit of thinner in there. Just to thin it down a little bit because I don't need the thickest coat in the world. I probably have it in the other room. Sometimes I use that stuff for thinning down paints. Alright. I'm going to fire up the fan and stuff, and we'll get going.
We'll be right back.
Alright, well that was pretty fun. Getting the black coat on. I am now going to take my black paint and just kind of run it out of here. When I do highlights, I tend to use ink, a little bit of either this stuff, or I'll even use, I haven't used a lot of this Higgins stuff yet. I just bought a box of that. But the Dollar Rowney stuff, it even has a picture of an airbrush on there, so there you go. I begin, actually, let me get my little cleaner up here. And, I begin, actually, by, I don't ever use that little dropper in there. I find that there often are dried chunks of ink inside that dropper that kind of go in and clog up my airbrush. But I will actually just pour the ink right on top of the black primer that's left over. That's left over in there. It will create kind of like a gray tone at first, and that's going to be the first of my highlight coats. And then I'll rinse out the brush and go back in with a pure white if I feel like I need it. These sludge figures, you know, I don't really need bright brights. I never really do, honestly. Because I don't really depend upon that, I guess. But, you know, we'll see how it looks. But I'm going to do both of the figures, and I'm going to do the plane, too. The battle kite, whatever you call it, right?
All right. Let's go back to it.
Alright, well, that worked out pretty well, but my airship here, my battle kite, is still really wet, because I did have to go in there with a lot of different details. These are the little these bombs are actually balloons that attach to the top of this, so got those done, but I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to save some of my highlight coat here. I'm going to dump this out. Pretty good looking stuff. I've got these little glass cups here that I can throw stuff in. And I'm just going to do a quick rinse and go back and prime those gabions that I actually kind of forgot about. Funny enough, I got so excited about getting to the highlight stage. I forgot I was actually planning on priming more. Well, that's what a relaxing hobby Saturday is all about, I guess. The black primer is pretty strong of a color, and I'm not going to really worry about the gabions too much. I'm just going to throw this primer right on top of that white. It'll probably cover it up just fine. And, again, I'm just going to put in a little bit of thinner just so that things don't dry as quickly on the tip. Acrylic paint, you know, like when it's blown through that little tip, it likes to dry out. And, then I get, like, little clogs. But I find if I throw a little bit of thinner or flow improver in there, I don't really know the difference between the two, chemically. If I throw that in there, I get fewer clogs, fewer things. If I feel a little bit of a clog, I'll just shoot it out, really, just shoot it up. All right, let's prime up these gabions and see what we can do. maybe I'll do a quick thing on how I clean my airbrush. One of the things I do is I got just a little bit of paint left in there, not a whole lot, but I'm gonna dump that out into this little glass coaster that I got there, right? And then first thing I do, I've been collecting these bottles that you use with dishwashing fluid, just because this nozzle is really great for just kind of dumping some water in there. And one of the things that I found is that once I start cleaning the airbrush, I don't want to send any of this primer through the airbrush anymore. That's just asking for trouble, because I'm scraping off dry stuff on the outside here. You know, so I'm just going to kind of like dissolve with water what I can with water, because, and I'll just dump it in there. Just kind of get that there. And I've got another big container over here. This thing, and I'll just kind of continuously dump stuff in there too. This is all full of garbage with like paper towels and old Q-tips and stuff like that. And about once a year or so, I'll have to chuck that out. But I just leave it down here because I don't care. Anyways, I'm going to just rinse out what I can out of here, right? And then most of this is like water-based stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just put a little bit of airbrush thinner in there, but not a lot. I'm just going to get a little puddle of that in there. And this stuff is a little fumey, which was like my whole idea of getting an airbrush and going away from all the VOCs of rattle cans. So anyways, I just use this a little bit just to kind of coat on the inside. Primer is pretty sticky. When I do like actual painting with an airbrush, I will not have to scrub this off as much, but primer is really sticky, so whatever. And then I'm gonna still dump most of that out. Oops, undid my moisture trap a little bit down there at the bottom. There you go. And then I actually did like off camera, I kind of had a little bit of a clog, and I had to undo the nozzle and little spill that I had. So I'm just going to dump a little bit in there. And I've got this guy, and I turn on my filter. I'd usually be wearing a mask during this part, but I like to get this in this can and then fire that through. There we go. And then I'm going to take off the cap, and I've got a little there's a little skeleton arm in there. I've got this little Altoids container, just a tiny little container. I don't need something big on there. Grab my little wrench, and I take off these caps. These guys I like to clean out really well, so I will toss some airbrush thinner in there and just close that up for now. Shake them around there a little bit. Then this needle's pretty dirty, right? So I just open up this guy and I pull that through. I try not to pull it through backwards because it will drag all the paint through there. And you can see I got a fair amount of gray primer stuff on there. So this needle I'm going to wash out. But before I do that, I have this over here. Let me detach the cord. I've got this great big ball jar with a clamp on it. And I'll just take my whole airbrush and stick it in there and shoot it in that water a little bit, right? That's gonna cycle it through, but I can leave that hang in there and nothing's gonna dry, and then I can take care of my needle and all the other stuff that I need to take care of, right? So anyways, needle, I just usually just wipe it clean. I usually don't need to do anything other than wipe it clean. But one of the things that makes it easy to clean is I got this airbrush lube. Who knows what it is, like baby oil, probably something. But I paid extra because it says airbrush lube. And I coat that I always coat my needles with a little bit of oil, just because why not? They're expensive, and if I get any corrosion on those, you know, like that's probably where it's going to happen. Stick that back in its case. Then these little guys, those are soaking in there. Again, grab a Q-tip and just kind of ream that guy out. See if I can wash out. Then I often bring that over here, rinse it out in that same container with my brush. And that's pretty well. Grab a little toothbrush and give it a scrub if I need to. Only because I spilled that primer on it is because I need to do this. I usually don't need to do this. I usually don't spill. But, you know, I guess if you go on camera, then, you know, you're going to spill. So I just wipe this guy off. And then, grab that oil again too, and I'll get a little bit on a, and I'll just go ahead and oil the threads, because you know I do. And then this tiny little guy, rinse that out. I don't actually use these kind of like scrub brushes very often, these like little things that you shove in there. Find those to be of limited use. But one thing I like about this is after a little visual inspection, I can take this bottle that my dishwashing liquid came in, and I can just squirt water through that, right? And that makes sure that it's all rinsed out. Ta-da! All right. And then, again, because I'm that guy, I'm going to put a little bit of oil on the threads and the tip. Drop that in there. Whatever. One thing that I like about this Talon, the Paasche Talon, as opposed to the Sotar, is that it is kind of like, I don't know, just a little less low maintenance. It's less fiddly with the maintenance. The parts are bigger. For general priming, I just find this to be really kind of nice. Right? Throw the rest of this stuff in here. Let's see. And then airbrush. I got that. And that is pretty well clean. I can clean the outside of that a little bit. I don't care too much about the outside. Every once in a while I'll go around the outside and I'll really clean off that chrome if I really feel like the need to. I like to get the stuff off of the threads, because that's a little nasty. And usually, like I said, I don't spill a bunch of primer all over the place when I do this. I did it today. I don't know why I decided to spill today. There we go. Get that all wiped off there. Just wipe out that cup. That's looking good. Right? As long as I didn't drag the needle through the body, there shouldn't be anything past here, right? I mean, like, that's only the way it could flow. So there shouldn't be anything down deep inside there. But I did it right. Which, today, who knows? It's always the time. I've had to, like, maybe ream this entire airbrush out once, and that was when I was taking the needle out the back. It was just kind of a simple thing to remember. All right. So then this stuff, I'm going to dump in there. I'll wash that out in the sink. I just got to store my airbrush sitting right here like this. I'll empty out air traps, or moisture traps, sorry. So empty out moisture traps at some point, but it's really dry down here, so doesn't really need it so much. And that's about it. That's like my airbrushing adventure for today. Thanks for, you know, hanging in there. And